Welcome back to The Breakfast here on PLOS TV Africa. Our final conversation this morning still is on the crisis with the two major political parties in Nigeria, the APC and the PDP. Seven National Working Committee members of the PDP resigned in the latest news, and there are rumors that it might just be because of the controversies with the leadership of Uche Secondus. And also, in the APC, Maimala Buni has his own fair share of crisis with the ward congresses and legal battles that seem to be upcoming. We're going to be bringing in this morning Professor Kenneth Nweke, who's joining us from River State, to share his views on these, you know, issues. Good morning, Professor Nweke.
Thank you and good morning. How is Lagos?
Lagos is beautiful this morning.
Good morning.
All right. Nigeria's two major political parties seem to be going through, you know, some turmoil, as it seems. What would you describe as what might be going on in the PDP, or let's start with the APC, rather. Does it seem like they might be shooting themselves in the foot as, you know, these decisions that, you know, they've made in the last couple of months seem to be biting them back?
What else do you expect? A political party, this is the, these are part of the activities of political parties. So when you don't get these vibes, so what else do you get? And so, I mean, what else do you get? These vibes are expected. Politics is all about struggle for power. And so when these things happen, for me, Nigerians make these things as if you know, something else has happened. No, no. It's expected. What else? What is going on in APC or PDP or even the proposed parties that will come and all that? They're expected. Struggle for power. Struggle for power. Politics is all about that. And so individuals will go for their interests. Those who also speak purportedly for the masses, for the people of Nigeria. If you look inward, they are speaking for themselves. Except those of us who can spare our time just talking for the good of Nigeria. But even at that, we still think about our individual interests, even as you are all in the studio. First, thinking of yourself. Me, you, and all that. That is the problem of Nigeria. It's not these distractions that we're hearing, getting here, getting these vibes. These vibes are expected. 2023 is also coming. And also, so what do you expect? It is a political contestation. You know, for leadership, people want to aspire to be in control. Nobody wants to, one, you want to get money. Two, you want to be it all. You know, the man that says, go here, and people go, and all that. So Nigerians like that type of thing, and all that. So what you're seeing in APC is expected. So the decisions that APC may have taken in the last few months and all that, maybe like you said, hunting them and all that, what else do you expect? Political parties will make mistakes and then they will correct themselves if they also understand why they are there and all that. So it's expected. Whether in the PDP side you have seen people resigning and all that, so what's the issue there? What should interest us so much? What should interest us is about, you know, how to bring Nigeria, of course, to the path of progress. It's not about those distractions. For me, they are mere distractions, you know, distracting Nigerians from really focusing on asking relevant questions, critical questions, fundamental questions that can bring about the desired change in Nigeria. And so on the path of the masses, on the path of Nigerians who have continued to pay those high over without telling status quo. They are all comfortable with any new status quo that they find themselves. It's about, you know, their survivor. Whoever that comes to power and then survives them, we got to be the glory. And they go sleeping and all that. And so now it's about APC. And then now it's about the PDP. And then we got into some kind of... what's our interest? Our interest should not be about what is happening among themselves. Because those who have resigned, if you also look at their position, their deputy. So, not to undermine the relevance of deputies in the organization and all that.
Professor Nweke.
So, I mean.
Yes, Professor Nweke, there are lots of, can you hear me? There are lots of reasons that have come up as to why these seven PDP leaders resigned. First of all, they mentioned that the leadership of Uche Secondus was poor. They also went ahead to bring out evidence to say that about 10 billion naira that, you know, accrued from sales of nomination forms in the PDP from 2017 till date were being paid into a private account of a man called Morufu and not the PDP PDP party account. What can you tell us about what indeed is a fact regarding why these seven leaders resigned?
You see, I don't have problems with anybody resigning. Anybody. I'm sure that they decided one day that they would find themselves in those positions. And they also decided yesterday that they no longer want to remain in the positions that they are having. I don't have problems. It's personal choices of these ones to resign, for goodness sake. And Nigerians should not bother themselves about who is resigning, who is not resigning. Nigerians should bother themselves about, you know, how to make a difference. We have how many, over 70 million Nigerians that are usually registered. So how can we up that? How can we take that to 100 million plus and all that? And then how, you know, election, round of election, cycle of election, how that over 60% of us to vote. So that we can actually make, you know. And so that should be our major concern as Nigerians. And not about what, you know, Nigerians deciding to go get their PVCs and take the patient in lining up on election day to say, look, I want to vote, you know, I want to vote our consciences. I want to vote, you know, after explaining candidate A, B, C, D, irrespective of party life and all that. We want to see more Nigerians who have the interests of Nigeria and Nigerians, you know, emerge in political contestations like those. And so those are the things that should concern us. Not APC making a mistake in whatever, you know, in leadership, and then some people being aggrieved about, you see, about what money was not properly used. If they were also given those that position, you know, that is occupied by the number one man in that party today, would they do anything different? That's the question. Would they do anything different from what Secondus is alleged to have committed? I'm not either speaking for or against their actions or actions of the leadership of the party. My interest is, how do we enthrone a political leadership in this country that would make a difference from what has been in place? And so that difference can always come when millions of Nigerians can take themselves away from the level of docility that they find themselves today or yesterday to doing something different.
Yeah, but by saying,
look, on a day of election, they want to vote for any political party of their choice or candidate of their choice, knowing too well that they were not induced in doing so.
Yeah, Professor Nweke.
What I think that Nigeria should be thinking about.
Yeah, but Professor Nweke, the challenge, you know, that lies here is that, you know, it seems like the pathways to achieving what you're asking of Nigerians, it seems like these pathways are blocked because, you know, these same political parties are in control of every single detail and every single, you know, all the machineries that should lead Nigerians to this political awareness and freedom that you're speaking of. We still have challenges with registering more and more millions of Nigerians, you know, who want to get registered for the electoral process. There's still very, very little education with regards, the electoral process. And also the level of interest even in the process seems to be waning every day. So what would you say, you know, Nigerians, you know, still have any hope in with regards being able to make these decisions that you've pointed out?
Yes, it's clear. It would appear, my dear brother and sister, and the Nigerian, that there are roadblocks because two major political parties are there. Not even with the hope of the PRP that's been proposed by Professor Jega, and any other one or thought force that will be proposed in the nearest future that will give Nigeria the desire that we have today. There is nothing wrong in any of these political parties that you mentioned, either APC or PDP, in or even the new one, like I said, in delivering on the mandate. It's about Nigerians who find themselves in those political parties. It's not about the political party as the name, because those you find in either APC today, we are once members of the other party, PDP. And those you find in PDP, we are other members of APC and all that. And then even the third force, if as it were, that anybody will want to propose tomorrow, would also be drawn from any of these political parties, including other Nigerians that have been sitting on the fence and all that. But what matters here is not about the political party. It's about, you know, people themselves, Nigerians themselves, you know, making a difference. People have, if we recorded about less than 30 million Nigerians who voted in the 2015 and 2019 general elections, can we in 2023, you know, show up this number by, you know, increasing the awareness, just like what we are doing today, you know, what you are doing constantly, the media, and those of us who have left what we are doing, you know, to begin to conscientize Nigerians. And so we continue to do consistently what we are doing, you know, knowing too well that Nigerians are sleeping, you know, sliding to their slumber state and all that, without, you know, getting up to question, because they believe that there are roadblocks. It's either you get blocked, you know, when you want to go to the other side, either or this other side, between, you are caught up between PDP and APC, or even the third force to come. No. So, but even within those political parties, there are still good Nigerians. There are we these ones that emerge are from emerge from within the populace and others. And we grow up in our neighborhood. People know us, for goodness sake. And when these ones emerge as candidates of their political party, for goodness sake, you know, people can begin to also raise some kind of a political education, you know, during electionary campaigns and all that. So begin to see whether APC or PDP or even any other political party for that matter, you know, they begin to say, oh, candidate A for House of Assembly in this, you know, is a better candidate than this and other. And you begin to look at their pedigrees and other. How successful have these ones been in their business? How successful have these ones been in the public service or in the private services that they gave in the past? So people should begin to look at the pedigrees of this one and not about high-profile ones, about these other. No, no, no. We should begin to look at them from birth, you know, from how they were raised and all that, and how, not exactly about how they were raised, but how they also raised themselves and all that, you know, and how they found themselves in the public space and all that. And so you begin to, you know, assess this one, you know, from childhood, to begin to say, okay, look, this one can be trusted more than this one. So if you begin, you know, cutting across party lines, and so Nigerians begin to do those and vote those ones that they think that they have more confidence in, irrespective of the parties that they come from, whether APC or PDP or the PRP or PRE, whatever you call them tomorrow and all that. We should start from somewhere, not to begin to think that, you know, there are roadblocks, either you get stuck with APC or get stuck with PDP. No, Nigeria has a lot of space to you know, find a pathway for progress. We cannot continue to see ourselves as being stuck between these two major political parties. No, no, no. Even the new ones, they cannot provide a leeway ordinarily. But Nigerians can, within what we political parties that we find ourselves, to begin to do a lot in terms of using the power of their PDCs, you know, to show you know, some of them that they are disgusted with, you know, their way out and other. And if we begin from there, at least things will begin to change, you know, a bit. And not to feel that, you know, we are stuck. We are not stuck anyway. Okay. We have decided to remain where we are because we have refused to find, you know, a way out of where we find ourselves.
All right. Obviously, a lot of work still needs to be done. Sadly, it's not moving at the pace that, you know, a lot of people would have believed it will move at, you know, since 1999. But, you know, we'll continue to take the steps that are necessary and continue to have these conversations. Professor Kenneth Nweke, thank you so much. We enjoyed speaking with you this morning. Wish you a great day ahead. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, thank you. And remember, let's continue to do what you are doing. Because posterity will judge all of us.
Absolutely.
All right, yes, this is where we draw the curtain. But just to quickly drop in that breaking news story that we saw last night, that about three students from the Baptist school in Katy have actually been found alive. You know, the story was that they were kidnapped and then they were re-kidnapped by some bandits when they were wandering in the bush. But we'll have still have more facts to uncover regarding this, but three students have been found alive. And that's the much we can give today on The Breakfast. We thank you very much for joining us. I am Annetta Felix.
And I am Osaugie Ogbonwa. See you at 9.